This video will guide you through the installation process of GFI WebMonitor. Since GFI WebMonitor works as a gateway or web proxy, all web traffic will be processed by the product. Consequently, the system requirements for ensuring smooth operations depend on the amount of requests per day that that server needs to handle. GFI WebMonitor supports Windows Vista and newer workstation operating systems, and Windows 2003 and newer server operating systems, both 32-bit and 64-bit architectures. If your business already uses GFI WebMonitor, the installation process starts by detecting older GFI WebMonitor instances and its prerequisites. If there are any missing setup prerequisites, the installation kit automatically installs them. Note that some of the prerequisites might run in separate installation processes and have distinct user interfaces. During the installation process, very little user intervention is needed. Once these steps are complete, the installation will deploy files and registry values as needed. As soon as the installation process is complete, the post-install wizard starts. It will run a quick check on your machine to make sure all the prerequisites are there. Click on Get Started to go through six simple steps. First, you need to choose the network mode. Either choose Simple Proxy Mode to route client HTTP traffic to the GFI WebMonitor proxy server, and non-HTTP traffic to the Internet Router, or Gateway Mode to be deployed on an Internet gateway with two network cards, one linked to the local network being served and the second connected to the Internet. Next, enter your license details. You then have the option to enable HTTPS scanning to ensure you are not violating any legal and compliance regulations in your jurisdiction. Activate Block Revoked to block websites which fail a certificate revocation check against a certificate revocation list issued by the certification authority. You can also choose to enable Display Warning, Blocking Non-Validated, or Block Expired. The latter blocks websites with expired certificates. It also gives you the ability to decide after what length of time the certificate will expire. In this case, let's say 90 days. The next step is to specify what type of database to use with GFI WebMonitor. Use Embedded for a smaller Firebird-type database, or choose SQL Server for live systems, and choose the SQL Server that GFI WebMonitor will be pointing to. Then, specify the authentication that you'll be using and give it a name. In this case, we'll use WebMon, and we'll be using SQL Server Authentication. Next, enter the login credentials and click Next. Now we need to specify administrator's credentials. This will determine who will be permitted to make configuration changes. We'll use the default administrator account here. The final step is to have the basic details as well as specify SMTP and email notification settings, so any alerts or notifications can be sent to your system administrator. With that done, you're now ready to begin using GFI WebMonitor. If you have chosen not to use WPAD, a simple how-to guide will walk you through the steps needed to get started. Thanks for watching this video.